Hey guys, it's Coach Wadley. What I want to talk about in this video is our four variations of landmine presses. Now, I really like these movements for some of our overhead athletes or our athletes who are at a higher risk for shoulder injury, such as our volleyball players. The reason being is that this gets us that vertical press movement without locking them out over the top with a dumbbell or a barbell in their hand. This is also a great way for us to introduce the vertical press movement to our middle schoolers at OPS, who we want to get them comfortable with a weight over their head, again, without locking them out over the top with a free weight. So the first one I want to show you guys is a landmine press with our feet neutral, just meaning that they're on the same plane here. Barbell is going to start about maybe 3 to 4 inches from our shoulder, and as we drive this bar up, we want to think about our head following the bar, kind of leaning into it. Sometimes you see people who have a tendency to kind of arch at their lower back, and now they're just pressing the bar away from them. And that could potentially lead to some issues with our lower back that we don't want to deal with. We also just want to really focus on getting that upward rotation of the scapula and getting this weight overhead rather than pushing it away from us. Deep breath in through our nose, we brace our core, we drive up, lean with the bar. Bring it back down about 2 to 3 inches in front of your shoulder, deep breath in through our nose, brace, up for rep number 2, okay? Now, another way that we can do this is we can add a push press to it, which just allows us to dip our hips and then drive up a little faster. So we really get that triple extension at the ankles, knees, and hips like we would on an Olympic lift or our trap bar jumps or something like that. But again, just a nice little dip of the hips, drive. Again, head still follows the bar, lower under control. From there, you can actually go to a split stance, just a little more of a unilateral aspect here. Opposite foot is going to be forward. Always bracing our core. Same rules apply. We're still leaning into it. We're just a little less balanced now. And finally, we can take that to a half kneeling. Scoot back just a little bit. Opposite knee is forward. Head still following the bar. Deep breath in through our nose. Belly nice and tight. Drive up. Again, these are just a great way to really train overhead without putting too much stress on an athlete's shoulders who uses their shoulders a lot, again, such as a volleyball player. I found that these are really helpful for getting our younger athletes comfortable with overhead pressing.